Raz, dva, tři. Okay, so hello. Let me welcome my presentation about ICT Web. It will not be so fun as the one before, but at least I will try. So, ICT Web. We are working. Okay, I need to ask you, does anybody know what is ICT Web? Yeah, Java Web Start and Java, yes, nice. Okay, two foreigners, somebody from around? No, another question, is anybody using the proprietary GDK? Oh, okay, are you using also the plugin and Java Web Start? No, because the Oracle have some changes in the latest releases of the plugin, we will get to them later. Okay, what's awaiting us? The history of Java, because we need to know where the ICT app actually appeared. Then the ICT app itself, what is it, how is it assured to be valid, and how is it developed, and how the community is participating on ICT Web, and at the end, something about the future of ICT Web. So the history of Java. Well, from 1992, when it started in Sun Labs Project Oak, quite a long way. In 1998, the plugin appeared, and the just-in-time compiler appeared. Quite later, 2006, finally the OpenJDK, so the Java was fully open source, but it was lacking in actually in plugin and Java App Start and in much more, very easy use. So that's why the ICT appeared on a scene. And in 2011, OpenJDK 7 and the down of ICT, and this year should be here. Sorry? It's lightning talk. I will try too slow. Okay, then you will not see the end of my presentation. So this year, the OpenJDK 8 should be delivered among us, and it is already delayed. It had to be somewhere in the middle of the last year, but it wasn't. And also the JDK 9 was already announced. Well, bad button. Here we are. GNU ClassPass. GNU ClassPass was established in 1998 as a reaction to the Java, which was proprietary, and the community wanted to have an open source Java. So this is it. It has its own virtual machine, it has its own compiler, and it's home of a lot of interesting alternative virtual machines like Jacoco and JumpVM. And also later, GNU ClassPass plugin appeared, but well, it was not fully versed plugin, it was just some kind of stub, but it was able to run the applets. GNU ClassPass is really lacking in AWT, and since 1.5, it is lacking in much more. It's not going to be even GNU ClassPass 0.1. From our point of view, it's important that in 2000, the Project NetX have started, and Project NetX was the first open source implementation of Java Web Start. It was started by John Maxwell, and right now, it's a dead project, but it was adopted by the ICT. ICT is another important project around the open source Java, because when OpenJDK 6 was released, it was not buildable by itself. Only the blobs were released, and no plugin, no Java Web Start. You got all this as a proprietary blob. So the ICT project was established by the Red Hat effort, and its goal was to have the OpenJDK buildable, scalable, and to have it open source to for the open source systems. It taken NetX in 2007, and the members of ICT had added many security fixes and actually enabled it for the community. In 2010, the NetX, or the ICT Web as it was called, was separated from ICT, and it began to grow because community can now build it in less than a minute before you need to build it with the whole ICT, which takes 30 minutes or more. And after removing the proprietary blob and proprietary Java from the open source software, from open source operating systems, it's the only Java Web Start and plugin from the distros. ICT Web, as I told, was delivered from the NetX. It was a Java Web Start client. And in 2009, Deepak Bole took it, and based on the GNU ClassPass plugin, he rewrote the plugin from scratch. Actually, he just created an NP API, which is necessary to communicate with the browser. And then he added some patches to the ICT and wrote some classes around. And well, here it was. You just put the links for the browser, and you have your plugin working. as I told, there are some patches in ICT. That's it mean that IST web is working only with IST, not with the OpenJDK itself alone. We are trying to change this to upstream dispatches, but upstream have not yet adapted them, not even for OpenJDK 8. But for OpenJDK 9, we got some promises that there will be some common API. Well, I think I don't believe them, because we are asking, trying to ask them every half a year for the last 5 years, and still no solid reply. So when IST web was developed, when NetX was developed, it was one-man show, and it was not tested at all. If you consider it, it started in 2000, and the first test was written in 2010. You can imagine how many errors was inside. But well, now we are pretty covered, and you can try an experiment, and all the errors are catched quite quickly, and it's really easy to experiment. IST web is written mostly in Java. It's 66%, because NetX is Java, it's Java Web Start client, and it's Java client written in Java. And all the plugin jar is also written in Java, just only the small thin layer is written in C, which serves for communication between the browser and the rest of the NetX. We have quite active community. Actually, developers are about 10, and other community users are mostly doing some translations or some patches for their local business, because they are using IST web, and we sometimes broke something, so they find it and they patch it. You can see that the development is pretty straightforward. We have Mercurial repository, everyone can clone it, and then you just run a general AutoTools machinery, make all changes, review process on distro.pkg list, and then commit and push, and here you are, your change is in, and we are releasing approximately every half a year, so your changes can be pretty quickly live. We have a lot of tutorials, and the source tree itself is very well documented and organized, so feel free to contribute. Community projects. As IST web is quite now spread across the distros and quite used outside of this room, then people are really contributing, and well, we have no contributor in Google, and Google is trying to shut down the NP API, and it's wrong, because Mozilla is not going to shut it down. So we will have Google Chrome with Paper API, and we will have Mozilla projects with the old NP API. This is really worthy for some student thesis, some volunteer. If you know some student who makes to do some really nice thesis in a C language, told him about it, it will be really appreciated. And this is a project which is already running. Jogamp is something like IST. It's framework around the Java itself. They are trying to make pure open source Java, and they are going much further than IST itself. They are, I would say, even very aggressive. The Jigong is really free, and a lot of stuff is missing. And they are trying to port it, for example, to the Android, when you maybe know that there is proprietary Delvik, because the OpenJDK cannot run here, because there are licenses issues. However, nonsense it sounds. So what they created was the AvoTLS plugin. It's allowing to plugin to be draw outside of the AWT framework, and you just got the clean X11 window, and you can draft on it whatever you want. So mostly you need to use OpenJDK API, but it's working, and it's interesting path, because when we think that Oracle is shooting AppLess and Java Web Start down, the community is trying to port them where it's missing. So we hope that IST will not die. The Jigong project is going even much farther. They want to remove the proprietary certificates, because right now you need to buy a certificate if you want to have really good signed applet. So they want to port it to the GPG or Pretty Good Privacy or something similar, and to strictly revoke all the bought certificates, because they can be compromised pretty easily. Well, not easily, but they can be. And then all the signing is done or is out. Future of IST web right now is quite interesting, because in three latest CPUs updates, the Oracle have made many changes to defense in depth for Java Web Start and mostly for plugin. At first, there was the extended applet security in May 2013, which actually did that you need to approve, yes, I want to run this applet. Later, even the browsers adapted it, that you need to, so you need to allow it in the browser itself at first, then you need to allow it in Java itself, and then finally your applet starts to run. Well, we adapted this pretty quickly, and now it's working. But this October and this January, even more traps have arrived, the new security attributes in manifest file. These attributes are somehow trying to protect your application to be kidnapped, and so somebody cannot use your application on his server with his malicious code. But the theoretical attacks are known, so ITDAP is slowly going on when we are trying to somehow implement it. From this, it's quite sure that Oracle is trying to stop out of time. Yeah, you see we implemented something, and future of ITDAP is clear, but it needs you. Our community is really small, just 5 people really hacking and about 20 more. But there are security issues and they need to be fixed before they happened. So okay, out of time, and thank you very much.
Continue with productivity, better mobile email.